Explanatory notes are written by the organization called World Customs Organization. And explanatory notes is really like an encyclopedia for the tariff schedule, harmonized tariff schedule. So this is their current website, wcoomd.org. And if you click through, you can kind of see it. It's really, if you're going to do the classification professionally, this is one of the things which is very helpful, because they really fill in a lot of blanks which are not filled up by either customs or by the text itself, the harmonized tariff schedule. The problem, at the customs level, at the customs and border protection, they themselves, whenever they make an opinion, whenever they make some kind of binding decision, they very often go to the harmonized tariff schedule and open it up and cite it as a source of persuasive authority. And persuasive authority is really what it is, because it's not binding. They express opinions which are very helpful, but United States specifically customs are free to deviate. They are free to adopt a different interpretation, although the burden on them to adopt that different interpretation goes way much higher, because this source has been held, has been cited by courts, by U.S. trade courts, such as Court of International Trade. They've been cited by the Federal Circuit, Court of Appeals, which is even higher. And they just become the generally accepted source of authority. So how do these explanatory notes, how do they come up on the exam? So again, I described the casters here as an example. This is one of the exam questions that came up. And here is what you see, the word on explanatory notes. So when customs talk about explanatory notes, they presume you have some kind of knowledge. So of course, because customs examiners assume that you have an idea about explanatory notes, it's very important for us to talk about, because they came up before, they will come up again.